Midori Itō, who has had a troubled week, gets a final word of advice from her coach, Machiko Yamada, and takes to the ice. Technically the most proficient skater in the world among women, but problems in the original program. She is fourth coming in.
She has had 3 days of horrible practices, and the look on her face when they announced her name was more of relief than anything else. I think she is so happy that this day has come and the Olympics will soon be behind her. The pressure will be up, but first a triple-triple combination. Let's double into triple. Woman in the world to land this. She did it in 1989 to win her world championship. The triple axel jump. It's left her for 3 days. She hit one in warm-up, and she cannot hang on to the landing of this one either.
Pleasing to the eye was that of Christy Yamaguchi. And she is currently in first place. Nancy Kerrigan is currently in second. Tanya Harding is currently in third.
The jump that Christy missed in her slow section was a triple loop, and it's one of Midori's best. Look at the height, her air position, and the flow out of it. Seems you wait for the next jump. Another triple axel, and she lands this one. Unbelievable.
That only came 3 minutes and 10 seconds into the program.
And a triple Salco. What a shock. The triple axel has left her all week. She throws it 3 minutes and 10 seconds into the performance. She needed to do that in order to win a medal.
Do you think that will give her one?
Certainly will. That took a lot of courage. The judges know it. Every skater in the building knows how difficult that is. She's definitely earned a spot on the podium. What a gutsy performance for Japan's Midori Itō.
Is such a charming young woman. It has been painful for all who know her to see her go through the tension of this week. And how nice to see the smile, even if a bit wry, return to her face.
Well, she knows she has no chance at the gold medal. But for her to pull off a performance like that after the weeks that she's been here and struggle with the press, all the pressure was on her. What a great moment for Midori Itō.
After falling in the original program, she apologized to her nation for her performance.
She's been having trouble getting up in the air, believe it or not, Midori Itō of all people. So she comes down a little short of rotation, and when you do that, your blade's going sideways and not backwards, and you can't hold on to the landing. And then she does one at the end of the program when you're tired. She gets all the height she needs. She lands backwards perfectly. What a gutsy move that is. When your confidence is gone and you can still pull off a triple axel, even when you haven't hit one all week, fantastic skating.
Midori has lived with the Yamada family since she was 10 years old. That is Machiko Yamada. Midori Itō now 22 years old. World champion in 89, as Scott said. Second to Jill Trenary in 1990. Fourth last year when she fell into a camera pit at the Worlds in Munich. Backstage, Christy Yamaguchi watching from the skater's lounge. One young woman to skate. And here are the first set of marks for technical merit.
Whoa, 5'9", almost straight across. What a courageous performance to throw that triple axel at the end of the program. With all the problems that she's had this week, I'd give her 7.5s. Unbelievable courage.
And now we wait for the marks for artistic impression.
Well, her strength is her jumping ability. The artistic impression mark has always brought her down. Those aren't good enough to beat Christy Yamaguchi.
Those marks put Midori Itō in second, and Christy Yamaguchi has won the gold medal. 1 skater left to compete. Her name is Laetitia Hubert.